कल सवेरे लगभग 8:15 बजे से पानी चक्कर भी लगे कई पुराना खाना और उसमें वो लगा रहे हैं कि मोटर पंप एक चलना ही नहीं चला और ये बैटरी का फिर चलाना बंद हो गया फिर चलाना उसमें लग रही थी लेंच के बाद इसको जो बटन की लगाई उसके बाद उसमें हमारे बोर्ड में पाइप फटा हुआ थी उन्हें 3 बजे हुआ लेकिन फिर जा के 8 बजे पाइप चेंज करने के लिए 4:30 तक उनके साथ बना तो कहते हैं एक नंबर जा रहे हैं पाइप का
गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. प्रोफेसर विकास जी
गुड मॉर्निंग,
अनम्यूट.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर. आई एम ऑट.
गुड मॉर्निंग. सर आवाज आ रही है आपको?
यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल.
ओके. गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
गुड मॉर्निंग.
हेलो
हेलो. यस आई एम ऑडिबल सर.
यू आर ऑडिबल सर.
ओके ओके.
सर बस दो मिनट में स्टार्ट करते हैं अभी.
एक बार
हमारे पार्टिसिपेंट्स ज्वाइन कर जाएं सारे. विमलेश, हैव यू जॉइंड?
Hello, I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Audible, sir.
Okay. Good morning to all, and welcome in the sixth session of STTP on Advanced Manufacturing Technology and CNC and Robotics. In sixth session, our resource person in this session is Mr. Vikas Kumar, which already delivered a lecture on Monday. Okay. So he is a very versatile scholar. He is B.Tech in Mechanical Engineering from Institution of Engineering and Technology, Lucknow. And sir has done his M.Tech in Engineering Production Engineering from IIT Delhi. And sir is pursuing PhD in Robotics Welding from DTU. Sir is presently working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at Ajay Kumar Garg Engineering College in Ghaziabad. Sir has a teaching, training and search experience of 13 years. And sir has trained a more than 500 delegates and students in the industrial robotics field. Now I request our resource person, Mr. Vikas Kumar, please continue the session.
Thank you, Suryan sir, for introducing me in such a nice manner. So I'm just sharing my screen.
Okay, sir.
Just wait. So I think it is visible to all. I'm audible and my screen is okay, sir.
Visible.
Okay, sir. I'm just going to start. Okay, dear participant, we have conducted one session on Monday. In that, I have briefed you about why we should go with this automation and robotics, and what are the basic definitions and basic importance of this robotics. Then we have covered various classifications of robots, like we have classified robots based on industrial environment and based on service requirement. So these two classifications we have divided. And further, we have classified our industrial robots in two bases. One is on the basis of geometry and on the basis of their control system. So we have gone through the various geometrical robots, like it may be Cartesian, spherical, it may be articulated, it may be SCARA. So like that cylindrical one is also there. So we have classified our robot in this manner. And on control basis, we have classified like it can be like based on their trajectory planning and based on their servo and non-servo control system. So these are the things that I have covered in my last, or you can say previous lectures. Now in today's lecture, we are going to create a base for this session. So that base I'm going to utilize in this session for my support. So I'm going to start with this session with the robot operations. See, whenever you and any person going to buy any new robot, so they have to perform certain operation on that. Robot operation means you have to clear with this concept, robot safety concept. You must be clear with this robot jogging, how we can jog the robot. Jogging here means how we can move our robot from one location to another location. And the third and important operation is mastering. Mastering is nothing. In a simple manner, you can just understand mastering is setting reference of your robot. So reference we are going to set here. In same way, setting reference of your tool is known as tool calibration. So we have to calibrate our tool. We have to calibrate our piece or job, whatever job work we are going to perform. So based on that, we have to perform these five operations. So it is very, very essential. Before you enter in the programming domain, you should aware of robot safety first, then you should aware of this jogging concept. In most of the cases, I can say whenever you are going to teach or whenever you are going to program your robot, you have to move your robot from one location to desired location. Because robot always take the moment based on their coordinates. Whatever coordinates you are going to give, this particular manipulator is going to achieve that coordinates. So how we are going to teach that particular coordinates? We have to just move or just jog our robot from one location to the desired location. So jog is very, very important. In same, we have to set reference. So one by one we will see. So robot safety is very important. Under that, you have to remember, like, this is the very basic things that you always follow while you are working with the robot. So robot is always stronger than you, because in normal cases or on an average, industrial robots move with 1 meter per second speed. It is very, very high speed. You cannot see if robot is working with their full speed. So it will be very difficult to avoid. Suppose you come across in their path, it will be very difficult to save yourself. So robot is moving very high speed, and this line shows this is the work envelope area. So here robot can move anywhere as per your program. So don't enter in this zone. So this is known as safe zone. Beyond this limit as danger zone. So danger zone means where your work envelope of the robot can be planned. So this is like that. If you come in between robot path, so you will get very impact. So that should not happen. So always remember, robot is more stronger than you, and don't enter in danger. In same way, what is jogging? Jogging is basically moving your robot with different coordinate system. Means you can move your robot with axis specific. It is also known as joint specific. Joint specific means normally articulated robot having 6 degrees of freedom or 6 joint. So how you can going to move your joint, J1, J2 joint up to J6 joint. So that we will plan here, how we can move our robot. And also move our robot with respect to world coordinate system. So this is one type of coordinate system. We can move our robot with respect to tool and respect to base also. So these are the various methods with the help of that we can move or we can jog our robot. So these are the jog keys that find it with any teach pendant. Means suppose you want to move your robot in X direction. So plus minus X will be there. So maybe this is for joint one, this is for joint two, this is for joint three. Like that, you can move up to joint six in plus minus. So every joint having certain limit. Like normally robot first axis or joint one has limit of plus minus 180 degree. So you can move your robot in plus 180 degree direction and minus 180 degree. So see, there are some these are the keys that you can use, plus minus keys. For joint one, for joint two, like that you can use. Or here you have also one big button that is known as 6D mouse. 6D mouse. So with the help of that, you can also move your robot with various joint locations. So this is the first axis of the robot, second axis, third axis, fourth, fifth, and sixth. So you can move one by one all the axes with the help of all available keys on your teach pendant. So it's all about how you can move your robot. So that is very, very important. Without moving, you cannot go with your programming part. Now, mastering. Why mastering is important? See, robot has to move from one to another location. Suppose this is location one, L1, and robot has to move here, L2. So what is the distance between this? So suppose in terms of X coordinate, suppose this is X 100. From here, it is 0 to 100. See, if I'm going to remove this difference from here and I'm going to push here. So we have to change this. So difference is very, very important. First, we have to fix the reference. Then only we can go with X, we can go with Y, whatever that we have. So all things can be measured through one location. So that is robot 00, robot mastering position. So normally we have to fix each and every axis with some values. Like, yeah, like here you can see axis one is at minus 27 degrees and minus 27 degree. And here A2 is minus 90 degree. A3 we have put in on 90 degree, and rest 4, 5, and 6 we have given reference 0 degree. So here if this particular things we are not going to define, so our coordinates cannot be freezed. Suppose I'm going to move this location to robot from this location to this location. So what is the coordinate of this? So that is not known to us if I'm not going to fix all these points. So it means it is very, very important. We have to fix the reference of each and every axis. Then only we can perform our task. Like here, tool calibrations, again, on your tool. Suppose this is your robot and this is your tool. This is your tool. So we have to define some coordinate system on the tip of the tool. This is known as tool center point. Again, this is very, very important because suppose you have to move your tool, so you can easily move your tool if you have tool coordinate system, and that can be easily managed if you are working in a tool coordinate system. So this reference, setting the reference of the tool, like here we have make it 000, XYZ 000 here. And based on that, we are going to move our tool. In same manner, we have to define some reference to our base or workpiece. Suppose this is a table. This is a table. On that, suppose this workpiece is placed. And I'm going to define my reference here at the corner of the table or at the corner of the any job work. See here, we are defining our 00 at the corner here. So in that manner, you can just define your base and tool coordinate system so that it will be very difficult. It will be very easy to jog your robot. So jogging is very, very important because if you are not having proper knowledge of coordinate system, you cannot move your robot in a very quick manner. Suppose you are ready with all these five operations. If you are comfortable with safety, if you're comfortable with jogging, mastering and tool and base calibration, now you can easily enter in the programming parts. So how we can program robot, that we are going to learn here. So we can program our robot by online method or by offline method. Normally online method further divided into two category. This is teaching by teach pendant method, or again, second is by playback method. So these two methods are available. We can use any one of that, but there is some restriction with this second method, that playback method. I will explain one by one. So what is teach pendant method? Here you have teach pendant, means you have remote control in your hand. And suppose this is your robot, and you want to move your robot from one location to another location. So with the help of teach pendant, you can easily move your robot. So that can be done through these key that is available on X, Y, Z, different keys we can use to move different joints. And it will be easily saved by this teach pendant. The position of the robot can be easily stored in teach pendant and communicated to robot controller. But when we talk about this playback, as this name it says, playback means whatever motion you are going to give your robot, it is going to follow the same. It is going to record that path and follow the same. How it will happen? You just have to move your robot from your hand, and whatever point you are going to teach, it is going to store that particular point. But for that, your robot should be well equipped with various internal sensors. Then only it can store all these points. So playback method is only applied to that robot that is equipped with all internal sensors, like force and torque sensors and motion sensors. If it is available with that robotic arm, you can use this method. But there is some drawback. The very first drawback is, like, you can require very high memory space. How it is going to store all these points? Suppose this is point P1 and this is point P2. Suppose I am moving my robot from P1 to P2 in this manner, in this trajectory. So whatever trajectory I'm going to follow, it is going to divide this trajectory in 40 to 60 coordinates. like here one coordinate c1 c2 like up to c60 coordinates, it is going to store in between two points, it is going to store 40 to 60 points, and at the time of like playback it is going to recall all these 60 coordinates so that it is maintaining the same path. So for that purpose, you require very high memory space. Second drawback with this method is you can handle only small size robot. A small size robot, because you have to move your robot with the help of your hand. So if human being having a limited height, suppose your robot or manipulator having a very huge structure, so you cannot manipulate, you cannot like do programming or this motion things with that particular robot, because your height and robot height is having so much difference. Third and very important drawback that we have under this method is we cannot update anything. Suppose you have problem with line 7. Suppose you have written 10 line programs. In 7 line programs, you want to update certain things. You want to modify something. So you have to create again whole program. You cannot only repair one line. You cannot modify one line. You have to go with all line. So normally in case of like industry, this method, this teaching method is preferred. Now, second method is offline. So offline means here you have no robot physically available. Only simulation environment is available for you. On simulation environment, you just create your program. Whatever robot model you are trying to place in physical environment, same robot or same model you can call with digital library that is available with any software. So with that, you can just call your robot on the simulation window. You can also import various job fixtures, tables, conveyors based on your requirement, based on your need. So you can just simulate all those things in virtual environment and you can easily find whether it is working or not. Normally, before we go for actual implementation of robot on the shop floor, we always prefer to have simulation, because simulation always offer few good things. So like this is the simulation window. In this, you can see how we can perform simulation. Suppose we have this area and under that we have two conveyor and we have two robots. So how these two robots working one by one without any collision with any peripheral object or any robot. If that particular things we can justify in this software, yes, this layout is best for this particular task, then only we go for actual implementation. Suppose here in this much space, we have to mount three robots. So we have to check whether it is colliding or not. Maybe some collision will happen with some peripheral or robot to robot. We can easily judge on which height we have to mount robot so that the reachability is good in this particular situation. So all major things we can check here. So in programming method, like online versus offline, if we compare, so online versus offline, always offline gives certain good advantages. Like offline cell development is very easy. Suppose you have to create 10 robot cells. So 10 robot cell foundation, suppose you are going to create in actual environment, it take a month time or at least 2 weeks time. But in simulation environment, you can develop any cell, any layout within hour time. It is reducing your installation and commissioning time also, because on simulation environment, your robot is not going to like give you some error. It is always in a perfect condition. So there is no installation, there is no commissioning kind of things. So it will be ready for you. Third is it also avoids last minutes fixed to layout. Suppose you want some change in your layout. So you can easily do that change with the help of one click only. But in actual environment, suppose you are creating your layout on shop floor with the help of 10 robots, and on suppose this task will going to complete in 10 days, and on 7 days you realize this particular robot should be in this location. It is wrongly placed at this location. So you cannot change. If you are going to change that location, it will basically very hard to replace the foundation of robot from one location to another location because it involves a lot of money, a lot of time. So that is the problem. So if you check all these things in simulation environment, so this wrong thing never be going to happen in actual or real world. Fourth advantage that is offers is reduce reduction via animation. So we have seen in the video, if you are doing simulation and if you are checking whether robot is colliding or some collision kind of thing is happening or not in simulation environment, that is not a it is not going to happen there. So you can easily replicate the same thing on actual environment. Now, last and very important thing with robot simulation, you can validate your cycle time. Suppose you are having 10 ideas in your mind, like I can place my 10 robots in this manner. So, but in actual environment, we have to implement only one layout. We cannot go with all 10 implementation. So which layout will give you a good cycle time? Cycle time here means productivity. So how can we check all these 10 layouts results? So you can easily go with your simulation environment. You can plan all the environment. You can plan all the layouts on the virtual environment. You can just check which layout is going to give you a maximum cycle time or minimum cycle time. So based on that, you can select which layout is best suited to you. So the idea here is that you have to learn with this slide. Normally, before we go for online implementation, we are going to prefer this offline first. If on offline environment things are going well, then only we go for actual implementation. So each and every industry having at least one simulation room, in that they are creating this layout and other things, they will analyze which layout is going to best suited for them. Now, suppose we are ready with operation, we are ready with programming concept, but as a customer, suppose I am hiring you for my problem solving. So what is my demand with my solution provider? So program solution provider means your program should be efficient. Whatever program I'm going to get from the third party, it is free from error. It should be easy to understand. It should be maintenance friendly. Maybe you require some modifications later on, so you can do that. Fifth one is it should be clearly structured. Clearly structured is very, very important because the flow of program, if you are well or if you are comfortable with the like flow of program that offered by the solution provider, so you can do any modification in later stage. And it should be economical. Economical always refers the production rate. Maybe for my problem, I will receive two programs, but one program, suppose I'm giving two programs, program one gives me 160 second cycle time for one product. And at the same time, I receive program two, but this programs give me 150 second cycle time. So this program is very economical for me because it is going to increase my productivity and other things. So in that way, so if your program, your offered program, or suppose you are creating your program for your own industry, if that having all these six characteristics, that means you have very good command on this programming things. See, kind of different programming languages we are using. So I'm going to discuss that thing in this slide. See, every company having their own language. The basic drawback with industrial robot is that each and every company, you just see here where I'm just marking, each and every company having their own programming language. Like if we talk about ABB, their robots program with this RAD language. If you take this example, KUKA robots, if you have KUKA robots and you want to create some program, so you have you need some awareness regarding this KRL, KUKA robot language. Suppose you have Kumau robots, so you require PDL language information. In same way, there are different make and different languages. So at this point, you feel difficult because in industry, you cannot judge whether you are going to get only throughout life, your lifetime of your service, you are going to only work with KUKA or Kumau or ABB. It may be mix of that all brand, or it may be purely suppose you work with KUKA and later on you have to work with FANUC robot. So how you can go adjust yourself? But the best thing with all these robotic languages is that if you understand the basic concept of programming here, how they are basically managing all this programming, all this application programming, you can easily adopt any programming language. It will hardly take hours for you. If you are good in any one of the language, if you are good with, like it is similar to like if you are good in C programming, you can easily adopt this Python. You can easily go with other languages. So in same way, if I'm good with KUKA robot language, I can easily digest all the other make programming languages. Because the beauty with all these languages, they are purely structured. If your program is purely structured, that means you have this kind of flowchart with you. Means you know how I have to proceed. Like I have to here take a start, then I have to put here some condition. If that is yes, it will going to happen. If this is no, it will going to happen or it will going to execute. So if this kind of flowchart or this kind of structure you have, this is the best way I'm saying, suppose you want to kill any problem with respect to your program. It doesn't matter what is your language, what language you are going to use for cracking this problem, but every logic you have to create or you have to start with this flowchart. If you are good or if you have created excellent flowchart in front of you to kill that particular problem, to solve that particular problem, you can easily frame this flowchart into your desired language. So here it is very, very important you are good in paperwork so that you can easily convert that particular concept or that particular logic in any language. So normally if you have any programming problem, so it is start with customer inquiry. First customer inquiry will done, then some briefing, then we said we are going to define some goal, what we have to achieve, then situation analysis, which type of equipment, which type of hardware, which type of environment we are having particular industry, then only we can offer good program. So you are very good programmer and we are not considering the situation of that particular shop floor. So you are not going to give perfect program to that particular company. So you should be aware with the situation. You should be aware with the requirements. Then you can start programming. Procurement can be start, whatever robot, whatever tool, whatever peripheral devices you want. Then all procurement devices should be configured. Then all should be programmed in a logical manner. Then we have to perform some documentation so that in later stages that can be modified or rectified. So these are the some basic questions when we have to plan, when we are planning to like crack any problem, what does your program do? These are the some basic questions that customer asks with any programmer, what kind of input required, what output it is going to supply, what must the program be operated, what is the operating condition of the program, how your robot or how your program is going to behave in like fault condition, in malfunctioning condition. So these are the few things that you have to always keep in your mind. Now, what I'm saying, if you are good in flowchart making, like suppose I'm a customer, I'm trying to solve my problem. So what I have to communicate, my need statement in front of my robot programmers. Like I want to weld this job. So this is my need statement. Now further, I have to go in more depth. So programmer will solve problem with this flowchart. It is going to give you an idea, like in this way, I'm going to achieve your solution. I will first check this, then this, then this. I will take care of this input, that output. So that can be easily communicated to you. If you are not good enough in any programming language, but anyone can easily understand the flowchart, like what logic I'm going to use, at what step I'm going to use what conditions. So if that is perfectly done and it is given green signal by the customer, yes, this flowchart or this problem solving technique is okay with me, then it is now up to you. You can easily convert this flowchart into any language, maybe Pascal, C, Python, Java, whatever language you are comfortable. Or same can be converted, same flowchart can be also converted into robotic language. As I said, robot programming, learning robot programming is very, very important for you. And for that, you have to understand these three components: motion component or motion command, B is logic commands, and C is technology package command. So in any make of robot, maybe Fano, Kuka, ABB, Yashikawa, any make of robot, whatever language they are using, all languages having the combination of motion commands, then logic commands, then teach technology package command. You cannot avoid these commands while you are creating your robot languages. So robot languages or learning robot programming is a skill. Say, I'm just going to give you a very, very basic example. If you are good in Kuka robot language, if you are learning this Kuka robot language, suppose in 2 weeks time or 4 weeks time. So this 4 weeks time, if you, how you have to plan your robot, how you have to like create your programs, all that. So it, and after that, after learning this KRL, suppose you have to work with this Fanuc using some different language, suppose VAL. Varial assembly language they are using, suppose. So can you easily switch from KRL to VAL? Yes, you can easily switch, and it will hardly take 1 day time. Here you have invested around 1 month, but switching from one language to another language, if you are having good command with KRL or with any language, you can easily switch. See, it is like that. Suppose you wish to like learn driving. So you start with driving, and normally 800 or Alto will be used for like this driving schools person. So you are learning driving or this car driving skills on 800 car or multi car. And suppose after 15 days of learning, you are going to purchase, suppose, Volkswagen, Audi, or any big name, any big brand car. So can you drive that car? The question is, here you have learned all car driving skills on your 800 or Alto or Maruti make. Can you switch to Volkswagen, can you switch to Mercedes, can you switch to any other brand? Yes. The straight answer is yes, because car driving is a skill. A skill means how you can manage ABC. How you can manage accelerator, how you can manage brake, and how you can manage this clutch. So it is all about ABC. How like good you are in managing all these ABC things. So that is same with all make of cars. So this ABC is similar to this one. Means all robotic language having A is motion commands, B is logic commands, and C is technology package. So here you have taken car learning. Here, suppose you have taken 15 days time. But from 15 days, if you want to switch to another make or another variant of cars, it hardly take 1 hour time. Hardly take 1 hour time. Only learning the functionality of that car. So in that way, if you are good with any language of robot, so you can easily switch to different language. So what is all these three commands that I am going to brief you, how you can like manage this motion, how you can manage this logic, how can you manage this technology package. See here, if you are having good command over motion, motion means you have to take care of all these things that I'm going to discuss, means trajectory planning, how your robot is going to move in random, this PTP motion, or in linear manner, or in circular manner. So here we are doing some path planning. Motion itself, here we have to do some path planning. Suppose I'm moving my robot from one location to another location in linear manner. So that is good, but few things we have to few inputs we required. Like one is at what velocity I am going to move here from one location to another location, with what tool I am going to move, or what workpiece or base I am going to use for this movement. So if all these things is defined under your motion block, motion command, means first is trajectory planning, then velocity, then tool, then base or workpiece. You can, if that thing is clear, you can easily plan your motion. Now come to the second one, logic commands. Under logic, as name itself says, logic means you have to work with certain logic. Suppose I have to move my robot from this location to this location, and further from this P2, from P1 to P2, but from P2 to P3, I come after taking 3-second break. So this is a logic, like my robot is moving from one location to another location, and from another location to the third location. So I have to take 3 seconds break. I want to take 3 seconds break. So that can be comes under some logical commands. So this is time dependent logic. Time dependent logic or wait command that you can easily implement in this. So it can be signal dependent also. Signal dependent means, like suppose we have written one logic. If input number, suppose this is my input number 1 is true, then only my robot will move. So suppose this logical command given, so this is signal dependent, means some input should be high, then only my robot is going to move from one location to another location. So logic can be anything. It can be related to your for loop, your array, your structure, anything, any loop or end loop. Suppose I want to run my program in a different loop, so that can be also planned under this. So logic is all about making your program more precise towards your application. Now coming to the third vertical, that is technology package. Technology package is like that. You have, suppose, before that, I just want to give one example. Suppose you want to open Word file. Suppose you have written one application to your HOD and you want to take printout of that application. And suppose you are using one desktop, in that Office is not installed. Can you able to open that Word file, that having .doc extension? The straight answer is not. You cannot open this doc file because you have not that environment in your desktop. If that Office is not installed, you are not going to open this Word file or doc file. So what you required, you have to require, see, PC or desktop is one system, big system. In that, some small module you have to install, some small software you have to install, so that you can work with comfortable zone. So here, in same way, suppose I want to use my robot for vision application. Suppose I want to use my robot for arc welding application. Suppose I want to use my robot for painting operation. So it is going to make that particular environment in that related to your application. this will ask for input. Suppose I'm going to install Arc technology package. I'm interested in welding application. In that, I have installed this Arc tech. So what kind of input I have to give in? I have to define my current. I have to define my voltage. I have to define my gap, feed rate, gas flow rate. So all these inputs, it will directly ask. So it will be a very simple for you if you are installing this kind of software, that application you are going to target. Suppose I'm going to target this laser welding application. So I can easily install laser tech so that parameters can be easily handled. Laser on, laser off can be easily managed. So all these things comes under technology package. So try to understand, if you are good in all these three concepts, all these three elements of robot programming, means if you are good with this motion, if you are having good knowledge of logic and good knowledge of technology package, you can easily program any robot, any make of robot in a very few time. See, if I have to define the ratio of the importance, or you can say the contribution of these commands in program, suppose you have 100 lines program. So normally you can find 80 lines with this motion. Motion is having very major role in robot programming. Then you can say around 10 to 15 lines with logic, and very few lines, because suppose I'm using Arc tech, means I want to perform welding. So at any point of movement, I have to initiate arcing. At any point of moment, I have to stop this arcing. So like that. So arc on, arc off, it is very, very few lines. So maybe only few lines, like 5 lines is the contribution from technology package. So this is the normally, I'm just giving you idea. Suppose I'm going to type 100 lines program for any application. So you can define ratio of all this in this manner. Like it can be 80 lines of motion, 10 lines of logic, and then further 5 lines of technology package, like that. Here, one by one, I'm going to explain what kind of different motion you can say. As I said, it is random motion or PTP, point to point. This point to this point, suppose I have to move. So it can randomly go from this location to this location. In same way, I have to suppose move linearly. So this is the way. So this is circular motion. In that I can move from, with the help of some arc. So in motion command, velocity is again important term. Selection of tool is again important term. Selection of workpiece is again very important thing. Logic commands. So here you can find some more depth of logics, like for loop you can apply, while loop, repeat loop, loop end loop. So these are the different counting, rejecting, non-rejecting, endless loop you can implement. You can implement this switch condition based things, if then else. You can also go with the switch statement. This I have already discussed, maybe time based logic, maybe signal based, maybe switching based, you can easily implement. Just give me 1 minute time. I have to attend one very important call. I'm coming. Yes, I'm back. Sorry for this inconvenience. Yes. So last is I have discussed in more detail what is motion, then what is logic, different kind of logic we can consider under robot programming, and the third element is technology package. So technology package, I have given example here. Under this technology tab, you can find different technology package. Suppose I have to manage my gripper. So gripper state of the gripper, you can say here state, then gripper is open or closed. So it can be easily managed, open or closed. So like that, you can implement these technology package in your program. Let's start with this structure of programming. See, now be careful here. I'm going to show you all elements of robot programming in this program. This is suppose a default program, any simple program that I have created under my teach pendant. So very first line says this pic is basically program name. So this is your name of the program. Then see here, this PTP. I'm going to define this PTP home basically. Home is the reference. You are just setting your robot with reference. Now this PTP, P3 points, and this here we have defined some velocity. We go for 100% velocity. I'm taking this tool number 2. Base number 1 for my program. So you can also give some name to your workpiece, your tool. So like that. So all this information that I have already discussed with you is present here. Means in any motion line, you can find which type of motion I am going to implement. Then what is the velocity? What is the tool? What is the base? These 4 element is very, very important. So in same way, we have somewhere we have defined in linear. So these are the things. So these are the things that we have defined under motion. Now come to this particular thing. So here in this, what we are trying to manage? We are trying to manage our technology package. So our technology package is here. You can say gripper. So grip tech. So here gripper is our technology package, and we want to make gripper close here. So this is technology package. Now I'm going to show you the third element, that is a logic. Third element, logic, you can easily find out. This is loop. This is end loop. This is your logic. And here also one more logic you can find, wait. So all these lines, line 3, line 11, line 15, this shows our third, that is logic. So we have discussed logic. We have discussed here this one, motion, and we have discussed also. So if I have to write initial, like this is our program name, this is logic. I'm just putting shortcut logic. This fourth line is basically motion block, motion command, again motion, again motion, again motion. This is your technology package. This is your technology package. This is your logic. This is your motion. 13th is motion. 14th is motion. 15th is logic, because I'm ending my loop. So these are the basic skeleton of the program. If you are good in motion, if you are good in logic, if you are good in technology package, you can create any program by using any platform. This is not limited to KUKA. It is same structure you can find with Fanuc, Safine. You can find easily with Yashikawa, ABB, whatever robot you are using. But you have to first learn how you can define all those things. Then only you can easily switch from one platform to another platform. So here in this blank slide. I'm just going to create one program so that you can having some understanding how we can approach or how we can create any program. See, I'm just creating one program for pick and place operation. So this is my program, pick and place. So suppose this is one robotic arm. So in that, this is gripper. So this is a gripper. This is a robotic arm that is fixed at one place. Suppose here one conveyor I'm going to consider. This is conveyor one. And here I'm going to give you conveyor two. So this is conveyor one, this is conveyor two. Suppose in this conveyor, I am receiving one job or one cube or one workpiece here. So this is workpiece. And I have to pick this workpiece from this conveyor. I have to place this workpiece at this location. Suppose this is L1 location and I have to place it at L2. This is L1 location and this is L2. So this is my basic problem statement. Like on these two conveyor, I have to manage this workpiece that is coming at location one. I have to pick that part from location one and I have to place at location two. So this is my basic problem statement and this is our manipulator that is defined by capital M. This is manipulator. Now, how you can start making your program? So first line, you have to define your program name. Suppose this is pick_place. So this is my program name. Always first line is program name. Then second line is your robot home reference. So you have to check your robot reference. Robot reference means, if you remember in robot operation, I have defined robot mastering. So robot mastering is always refers the reference of the robot. So whenever we have to check this robot reference, we have to put this PTP command and this home is a name of your reference. Home, or you can say reference of the robot. So you can put some comment by putting this colon like it is, or setting the reference. So what we are trying to do with this first line, PTP home, suppose. This is PTP home. What is our motive? It is for setting the reference of the manipulator. Now third line, we have to like cover this much distance so that I can come and grip this part. So just above this workpiece, I can define one point. Suppose this is P1. So I will move my robot with random motion. Like I have to achieve this P1 coordinate in PTP trajectory. And what is my velocity? Velocity is, suppose I want to go with 100%. Suppose I'm using this gripper T1. This T1 is my tool and this is gripper. And suppose this B1 is my base and that is my job. So I have defined all these four elements. Means first I have to define what kind of trajectory I'm going to follow, then what velocity, then what tool and what workpiece. So all things I have declared. Yes. Now come to the fourth line. In fourth line, what I have to do, I have to linearly come just above the gripping position. So this motion should be linear because I cannot go with random. And suppose this particular location where I'm going to grip is P2. So linearly I have achieved this P2. And suppose this is similar, whatever thing I have defined, it is same. Now coming back to fourth or fifth line, suppose I have achieve my position here. My gripper is like that, suppose. So I have to close my gripper. So I'm going to use my technology package command gripper grip tech is equal to close. Now, if my object is gripped here, then what is my second objective? I want again go and reach some above point of this conveyor. So 6 is means again I have to move linearly, and maybe I am achieving the same point so that I can safely come in air. So I am going to achieve P1 and with same concept. Then coming to the 7th line, I want to like move my robot from this location to suppose this location just above to this workpiece. Suppose this is P3 point. So in random motion, PTP P3, I will come and do all these things. Then at 8th line, I will linearly come from this location to this P4 location where I have to place this workpiece. So I have to move linearly P4. All things, tool base and other things should be same, suppose. Now at 9th, if I have achieved this P4, then I have to open my gripper. So grip tech command should be in open. And after open, suppose I don't want to come directly. I want to wait for some time. So I can also give wait is equal to 3 seconds. In similar way, you can also insert after gripping. You can say after closing, it will wait for 3 seconds so that it can be easily set. Now after like gripping, after this grip and open, workpiece is placed and conveyor to, I have to linearly come at this point P3. On the air I have to come. So again at 11th line I can write in linear manner I have to come at P3. Then after P3 I can come to robot reference position, that is PTP home. Then at 12th and 13th line it can be end of the program. So here you can easily analyze, like I'm just changing my color of the pen. See, this is wait command here. This is wait command here. So this blue color shows our logical command. Now come to the green one. So see here, grip tech and this grip tech. These blue lines, this green lines is our technology packet. Red lines we are basically representing as a motion command. So you can easily see we have few lines of logic, few lines of technology package. Rest lines belongs to motion command. So in this manner, you can easily create any robot programming language, any robot program for defining your application. So maybe suppose I want to put some more logic. Suppose this I want to run in loop. So I can put, after defining program, I can put here loop. So this is loop. And before end, I'm just writing end loop. So this program is going to run in a loop. It is endless loop basically. So you don't have to stop. It will run from morning to evening and execute all the things. So this is the way so that we can easily create our program. So I'm just quickly creating a logic for your robot welding application. Suppose this is your robot and this is my This is my welding torch. And I want to perform welding from 8, B, C, D. On this edge, suppose I want to perform welding. So you have to start again with, you have to define, suppose your program is, program name is weld. Now you have to check your PTP home position. Now you have to linearly come at this point. So in linear manner, I'm coming to point A and I have to define tool. I have to first define velocity, tool and base. So now after achieving this point, A location, I have to go with this technology command. Architect should be on. Means here we are igniting our torch. So arc is on. Now from this point, I have to move up to linear B, then linear C, linear D. From linear D to, again, we have to come linear A. Then again, after here, reaching here, I have to close my arc. So architect should be off. Then from this to this, I have to go in PTP. I can go with PTP at this, suppose this is my P naught point. So this P naught I have achieved, then end. Or you can say this PTP home, I should go with reference and then end. So again, in this, you can see, I have used only technology package here, architect, then architect here. Rest line belongs to motion command. So here I cannot find any logic, but I can put some logic. Suppose from B to C, I want to wait for 1 second. So I can put 1 second here time. So like that, maybe your program not required any logic. So you some in some conditions you can find, like we have three elements, motion, logic, and technology. So in some of the cases, maybe this logic is absent, but you cannot avoid this motion. You cannot avoid this technology package. So now quickly I'm coming to how you can select your robot. So based on application, based on your payload capacity, how many degree of freedom you want, what operating range and what is the repeatability. So you can find there are so many types of robots. Although robots can be used for any application, but if you want to robot for your foundry shop, so you can easily buy foundry robots so that it can easily sustain the heats. Here you can see the last arm of the robot is made through some heat resistance material. So it can be easily avoid some deformation through heat. So you can put your application, you can get that particular robot also. So robot can be mounted on the ground, can be mounted on the wheel, can be mounted on the rail. So there are so many manners on that you can mount your robot. Over the roof, you can also mount. So that you have to tell before you buy this robot. Payload capacity always defined. Robot payload capacity is straight away you can understand. The load carried by this robotic arm, means how many kg it can carry from one location to another location. So that is very, very important while you are selecting your robot. So number of axes is again very important, means how many axes with 4 degree of freedom or with 5, with 6, how many degree of freedom you want to work. So that is again one criteria. Then operating range is again one important criteria. Operating range means work envelope, means what area it is going to cover. So here you can say wherever robot can move, it is known as the work envelope or the operating range of the robot. Now you can also go with this repeatability options, like you want more precise, more accurate robots, that is also available. Suppose you want to perform some laser welding operations, for that you required very high precision. So there is a robot series that is known as HA, high accuracy robot. So that is also available with each and every make. There are some more criteria, like it can be selection criteria can be based on your life, your costing, control configuration, running cost, maintenance cost, noise, vibration, mounting and placement. So these are the few things that you have to keep in mind before you go for buying any robot. So there are some latest trend that is shown here, like robot human collaboration, that is known as Cobot. It is now in a trend. Smart grippers is always prefer under robotic applications. Like robot integration is very, very challenging area. So nowadays you can find just plug and play kind of robot. You can find good simulation tool also. You can also find cloud-based robots so that they can transfer their program. They can transfer their data from one plant to another plant. Robot are now based on machine learning. They are self-optimizing themselves. Means whatever program you are creating, if there is a chance of self-optimization, they will do that also. Like in Industry 4.0, the major thing that we have to touch is cyber physical system environment. So here you can say this is our physical system. This robotic arm is our physical system that must transfer some data to cloud. So based on some like networking, you have to transfer their data so that their operation can be optimized. Here you can say, if we discuss the productivity and industrial robots, so industrial robots always prefer where we required high productivity and limited flexibility. You can see here. So this is our advanced robotics area where we have to work with human being. See, this is the latest trend that is going on. If I'm going to mix few operators or few human beings with robot, what we are going to achieve? High flexibility and high productivity. This is the latest concept that is going on, and that is known as Cobot concept. Cobot concept means where human, this is a human and robot that is sharing common area that I have highlighted. So initially we are working like that. At one end robot is working and at one end human is working. But nowadays, if you see this is responsive collaboration where robot and human beings are working in real time. So that is very, very important to achieve high flexibility and high productivity. And if you are making your robot in cloud-based, so you can easily transfer your data. So here you can say robot doing the same task connected across all the globe location, so performance can be compared and improved at click of button. So it is very, very important. Again, you can transfer each and every joint data, each and every sensor data to your robot, from your robot to your plant. So that is very important for optimizing the things. This small miniature robots concept is very, very in a trend. Like we can have a small space area, like it can be fit into 600 by 600 by 600 cubical cell. So only this much space required. So because space is always a challenge for any industry, they cannot buy more and more space, but they can minimize the size of robot and they can maximize the profitability and productivity. When we talk about operation, this application, so application thumb rule is it can be based on environment, it can be based on task. Suppose you have to apply robot, so where, on which environment you can apply? So whichever environment you feel it is dangerous, dirty, dull or difficult for human being, so there you can apply robot application. This 4A is very important. Robot can be complete automation task, augmentation task, assistance. It can be act as assistant, autonomous environment. So these are the task-based classification. Otherwise, you can see robots can be used for industry. It can be used for domestic. It can be used for security. It can be used for space. It can be used for professional. But when we talk about only like industrial robot. So there is huge applications. Like you can start with this welding and joining application, palletizing application, assembly application, material handling, inspection, loading, unloading, machining, surface coating, and so many different industry, wood industry, aerospace industry, medical, building, machining, research, electronics, automotive, foundry, plastic, food, injection molding. You can name them any industry. You can easily find robots applications are there, available there. So this is the things that I want to like convey with this. And at AKGC, like where I'm working, I want to showcase various applications. Suppose in future you want to avail this facility for your students, for your faculty, you can easily contact us. So here we have, at AKGC, we are having robotic inspection, robotic vision system, robotic milling we are having, robotic deburring we are using, robotic ultrasonic welding we are using, robotic laser welding and cutting, robotic 3D printing we are using. Also, we are having force and torque sensors with robot. We have ATC, automatic tool changing. We have spot welding application. We have robotic CMT. We have robotic time twin. We are also in the WAAM technology, WAAM. The latest trend that is going on, metallic 3D printing kind of thing, wire arc additive manufacturing, where we are using CMT power source for creating 3D objects. And you can also find most also used for medical industry. So statics is very high. Like in 2018, 5,000 robots were sold under this medical facility. Predicted by 2022, around 20,000 robot is going to be sold in medical industry. And So I'm just concluding my presentation. After that, I have scheduled one robotic welding demo. I will that demo with you. So these 2 days talk can be concluded like to become world class, and automation and robotics technology will play a key role in that. All need to be geared up. So these are the things that you remember. If you are not good enough with this, you have to face tough time, because this is the latest trend that is going in and we have to follow this. So I'm just stopping my screen here, and I have connected with my mobile also. So with that, I'm going to showcase my few applications to you. I'm switching from my computer to my mobile. I will check whether you can see all the facility here or not. So just help me out whether you see my facilities or my voice here or not. Just wait. Hello, host. Hello.
Hello, Manish sir.
Yes, sir. I have connected with my mobile also with name Vikas Kumar. Can you?
So sir, that you are audible, but the screen is not visible.
No. Actually, sir, I am speaking from the computer only, but I want to switch on my mobile. So there, okay. I am not getting permission to unmute and.
Okay.
So can I left from here and you just make me host with my mobile?
Okay, sir. Okay. Vimlesh. Vimlesh. Wait a minute, sir. Co-host. Sir, you are co-host also.
Host with my computer, but not okay. With my. You can see.
Name is okay. There. Wait for a minute, sir. Okay. I am searching for your name with mobile.
Yes.
Vikas.
Yes, with same name I'm there.
सर ये कैसे बने आपको होस्ट? आपका नाम तो सर आ रहा है विकास,
विकास यस सर, बट मैं अनम्यूट नहीं कर पा रहा हूँ।
अनम्यूट नहीं कर पा रहे हो?
यस सर, वीडियो और बाकी चीजें ऑन नहीं हो रही। यस सर, इट्स डन।
व्हाट सर?
यस यस, थैंक यू सर। सो आई एम ऑडिबल सर? आई एम जस्ट टेकिंग माय मोबाइल। ओके, sir, kindly support me to start my video also, sir. Give me some permission. I'm able to unmute my mic, but not able to I start my video.
Sir, give permission.
I think same permission required for this video also.
Hello, sir. Yes, have you sir. Concluded?
Sir, I have concluded, but I want to show some practical applications to my participants. Can it is possible to switch on my camera?
Yes, yes. Is it possible, sir?
Sir, it is not like it is saying you cannot start your video because the host has disabled it. So make it enabled.
Please try now, sir. आपका
yes,
co-host
yes.
है, आपको तो सारे rights हैं.
नहीं सर, अभी हो गया.
Okay.
It is visible to use?
Yes, visible, sir.
Yes, thank you. So, dear participants, please see, this is industrial robots that we have at AKGC. This is 6-axis industrial robot. So, this is the basic structure of robot that you can say this is mounted on the ground. And here you can say this is tool, that is gripper basically. So, this is gripper, 2-finger gripper you can say here. So this is one conveyor that we have. This is a simulation facility that we have at our end. So here you can say through this we are able to like communicate how we can simulate any robot. We have few more robotic arm, like here we have this ultrasonic welding robot. This is ultrasonic welding gun. With the help of that we can do plastic welding also. This is KR6 robot. This can carry 6 kg load. And this we are using for vacuum handling. See, this is a gripper that I have. We only have to mount this gripper at this. And we have to supply compressed air to this end. And we can easily grip the object. This is the smallest robot that we have. That is KR3. Again, we are using this for pick and place. This is a robotic arm that we have. Now I'm moving to our advanced lab. In that, I'm going to showcase you a welding application.
So participant, this is our advanced robotics lab. In that we have four robotic arm. So you can see here, this is a spot welding gun. So here you can say this is a spot welding gun that we have. This is spot welding gun having weight around 120. So we are using this robot that is having payload capacity 180 kg. This is KUKA robot with time to an application. Here you can say this arc welding having two wires at their end. So this is two wires that is coming with this welding torch. The idea with this, we can do very high weld deposition. So this is like here you can say T-shaped. We are done seam welding here. So this is KUKA time twin. So one more robot you can say with this KUKA with the MIG welding robot. This is TR5 robot having big MIG welding torch here, you can say. And this is the power source that is from Fronius. And it is TPSI 400 I series. This is our fixtures. And this is our KR16 robot with CMT gun. So this is CMT. And we have this CMT power source, you can say. This CMT stands for cold metal transfer. So for performing welding, you required robotic arm. You also required wire spool. See, this is a wire spool that we have. So with the help of this wire spool and this power source, and this is our gas supply that we have. So here you can say some pressure is there. So for providing inert gas environment, so we are using this for this setup for welding. And this is common program that we have to write. So you can say I have created one demo program. In that you can see very first line here, PTP home, then linear, then here some arc on command is there. So arc on, we are using to switch on this arc. Then we have used arc off, then we have some linear commands, then PTP home. So in that way, you can say very few lines. It is having around 7-8 lines only, and we can easily create programs. So we are regularly getting some job work also. So see here, the quality of bead you can achieve under this robotic welding. It is very, very clean and smooth. We can do circular weld, we can do linear weld. So these are the job work. Normally we do this kind of job work for our industry persons. So I'm just going to demonstrate this welding. So he is my colleague, Ankit Dixit, is going to give you a demo. It's ready. See, this is a dry run. We are just doing drying run so that we can check whether it is perfectly moving with the defined path or not. This is our torch, and this is because welding cannot be done with very high speed, so we have to optimize the speed according to our welding parameter. So here you can say we have created one program. We have checked with whether it is working or not. So dry run is done. Now we are going to execute actual weld. So just see, be careful. So I'm just doing a welding here. So just see how it is going to happen. So you can see, this is welding process that we did, and robot has achieved their reference position. Now we can easily check the quality of weld. You can see here, we have created very good seam with robotic welding. So in that way, I have demonstrated how we can create program, and same program I have shown you on this T-pendant. So it is not very difficult field to learn how we can program any robot, how we can like develop any case application with this robotic arm. That is very, very easy. It is only required 1 month's time and your some focus on this area, you can easily adopt this technology. So this is all about from my side. If you have any query, you can ask me face to face, or if you have any query related to this robotics that we have learned under this 2 day session, you can ask me. Any participant, any query you have, you just tell me.
Hello, Sachin. Ask your question. Sachin, beta.
Hello.
Yes, yes.
Is I'm audible?
Yes. Tell me.
Okay. So first of all, thank you so much, Vikas sir, for this full of knowledgeable and enthusiasm. Full of enthusiasm.
Okay, welcome.
So my question is, when you're teaching about the motion commands.
Yes.
About PTP and linear motion.
Yes.
My query is, why the program? Matlab, how the algorithm work behind the point to point motion? Because we know the linear motion is the shortest motion, and technically the shortest motion should be the quickest one.
Yes. But
so can you explain me behind the algorithm behind it?
Yes, in case of robotics, always PTP motion consider as the quickest motion based on the current situation of the robot. मैं आपको एक एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ. सपोज यू हैव टू कवर 100 मीटर डिस्टेंस एंड यू आर इन स्टैंडिंग पोजिशन. सो हाउ मच टाइम यू विल टेक? सपोज इट विल कम 100 मीटर्स यू विल कवर इन 1 minute टाइम. सपोज 60 सेकेंड्स टाइम यू विल कवर. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू अनदर सिचुएशन where all the conditions are same, you have to cover 100 meters length only, but now you are in sitting position. So first you have to unfold your leg. Means first you have to unfold your leg, you have to make yourself straight, then you will start running. So in case of robotics, what happened? We have 6-axis robot. So all axis has moment, like it may be twisted at certain angle. So first, the algorithm will relax all the joints, then only it will start moving. So in that way, we say PTP motion is always quickest in current scenario. It is that, suppose I'm tilted my robots in left direction 180 degree, and I want to achieve position in right hand side. So what robot will do first? It will first untwist their angle. So it will start making itself at zero, then it will move. So like that, you can say, so robot always try to achieve this algorithm. And that is basically defined under robot controller. That is mathematical and kinematics part of the robot that cannot be covered in this platform, because kinematics with certain links having different phenomena that you can, that required some another session. In that I can explain that how any robots can be moved in forward kinematics and inverse kinematics, and how we can achieve different motions at defined time. I think one kinematics lecture is defined under your this STTP on last day. Yes, I have seen that. So in that you can analyze how robots can achieve different trajectory with what velocity and motion. So that is part of your kinematics. So we cannot cover that thing in this much short duration. But yes, it is there. Linear path is the shortest path, but you cannot always go with your this linear, because you have to take care of the robot situation also. So there is a term, status and turn. So two terms are there in case of robotic arm. What is the status? The status of the robot, current status, and what is the current turn? Turn means 1 to 6 joint, what angle it has turned. So based on that, it will take decisions how fast it can move. So I think I have answered your question. You. Yes.
Yeah.
Any yes, other sir. Questions?
Thank you so much.
I hope. If you have, any other questions anyone having?
आप आ जा सकते हो, आ जाओ तो बेटर, एक तो बेटर ना सकते हो, आ जाओ यहाँ पर बता दें सारे समझाते हैं आपको.
Sir, one student write in your chat box.
Okay, okay. I'm just checking, sir. If any of particular X is not mean. See, we have suppose articulated robot in that six axis we are trying to move. Suppose any axis is not moving, it means each and every axis having one servo motor. See, I'm just going to demonstrate here. Just see, this is KR180 robot. In that first axis is moved by this particular servo motor. This is one motor. If you go with second joint of the robot, this is second joint, another motor. This is third axis of the robot, another motor, you can say servo motor. And for the rest axis, you can say for fourth, fifth and sixth axis, we have different motors. So maybe there is a problem with, and every servo motor have these two cables. One is power cable and one is encoder cable. If you go through the principle of servo motor, you can find encoder having a very important role to check the current position of your motors. And so if any one of the cable, power cable or encoder is not working perfectly, it means that axis is not going to move. So you have to basically check your motor condition. This can only resolve these things. Otherwise, in some conditions, what happens, suppose you want to move axis 4 and you can see some other axis is moving. So that is basically condition of singularity. One term, I think you are aware with that, robot singularity. In that, robot get confused whether it has to move from one location to another location. So which trajectory or with path we have it has to taken. So there is a concept of robot singularity. In that, robot get confused because the number of solution from one point to another point traveling is more than one. So that is a singularity part that is not related to your this query. But yes, if any axis is not moving, that means straight away you have to check your motor conditions. Any other questions? Any participants?
Any other question, participants? I think, sir, there are no more questions.
Okay, sir.
Sir, let's wind up the session.
Okay.
Thank you very much, sir. You have explained very nice different concepts of robotics, applications, and live demo of the robots.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, participant. If you further want to explore this field, you can come and explore the different applications at AKGC. We welcome all the participants of this STDP. They can come and spend their 1 day, 2 days time at AKGC so that they can more explore this area. So we are always open to this kind of visit, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
So thank you all. I request you all to please join next session at 12 PM sharp. And I additional request, please join 1-3 minutes before the session.